Hello students, in the previous class we have observed the acid base titrations. Today let us discuss about the second type, that is redox titrations. So before going to this, let us discuss what is oxidation and what is reduction. Okay, so oxidation is nothing but, as we know, that it consists of loss of electrons. And reduction is nothing but here gain of electrons. If the electrons is losing, that one we call it as oxidation. If electrons is losing, gaining, that one we call it as reduction. And also we can say here gain of oxygens and removal of hydrogen. So this is also a oxidation. And coming to for reduction, we can say gain of hydrogen removal of oxygen. This one we call it as reduction. So oxidation we are saying, reduction we are saying. Okay, so when you combine these both, so the combination of oxidation and reduction, the combination of oxidation and reduction, we call it as redox reactions. Okay, the combination of oxidation and reduction, what we can say, redox reactions. So here we are having oxidizing agent and reducing agent. So what we are having, oxidizing agent and also reducing agent, we are going to have. So what is oxidizing agent? So here oxidizing agent is nothing but here decrease in oxidation number. That one we call it as oxidizing agent. If there is an increase in oxidation number, we call it as reducing agent. Okay, so if suppose I'm taking an example here to understand clearly, so here I'm taking 2FeCl3 plus NnCl2, it will give SnCl4 plus 2FeCl2. This is the general equation. So if I have been written in the ionic forms, that is 2Fe plus 3 plus Sn plus 2, which will give Sn plus 4 plus 2Fe plus 2. So these are the ionic forms. So oxidizing agent is nothing but what I have told you, decrease in oxidation number. If you have been seen ferrous, here the plus 3 is the oxidation number, here plus 2 is the oxidation number. By this, what we can say here, the loss of electrons is going to take place. So means what? Decrease in oxidation number. So this one we call it as oxidizing agent. Okay, if you have been taken Sn plus 2 to Sn plus 4, so here plus 2 is the oxidation state, here plus 4 is the oxidation state. So by this, what we can see here, increase in oxidation number. So by this, what here, reducing agent. Means the stannic ion is reduced to stannous, ferric is reduced to ferrous. If you write half cell reactions we have seen in the galvanic cell, in the intermediate, and also Daniell cell. Okay, so now oxidation half cell reaction. So here what you are getting here, the oxidation means loss of electrons, right? Sn plus 2 gives rise to Sn plus 4 plus 2 electrons. So this is what here, oxidation half cell. And coming to reduction half cell, so what we are getting here, Fe plus 3 plus 2 electrons gives rise to 2Fe plus 2. This is the reduction half cell. Means see here, the oxidizing agent is different, reduction agent is different. So the overall reaction, what we are going to get, the overall reaction will be here. 2Fe plus 3 plus Sn plus 2 gives rise to 2Fe plus 2 plus Sn plus 4. Okay, so this is the overall reaction we are going to get. So this is only no reaction we got here. So if you present in half cells, this oxidation half cell is losing 2 electrons. Loss of what I have told you, oxidation is nothing but loss of electrons. Here the electrons is losing. That's why we say oxidation half cell. But coming to here, the oxidation number is increasing. Okay, so this one we call it as reducing agent. This one we call it as reducing agent. This one we call it as oxidizing agent. So by this, what we can say, this is the oxidation half cell and reducing half cell, and this is overall introduction. Also, this is the introduction of the redox reaction. Okay, coming to here, this consists of generally the redox reactions depends upon standard electrode potential values. So okay, so generally I'll show you one table here. See, so this redox reaction depends upon the standard electrode potential values. If you have been seen here, MnO4 plus 8H plus 5 electrons means here the gain reduction half cell. So this is all a reduction half cell. So this reduction half cell depends upon the standard electrode potentials we have been seen in the intermediate, that is standard electrode potential values. So then what it is giving here, the electrode potential value is 1.52. For chlorine it is giving 1.36. For chromium it is giving 1.33, for mercury 0.79, for ferrous 0.77, I2 0.5754, copper 0.153, Sn plus 4 0.15. So by this, what we can say, these are the electrode standard potential. So which one is having more electrode potential value here? This one means MnO4 is having more electrode potential value. So by this, what we can say, so here what I'm saying here, this MnO4 minus MnO4 plus 8H plus plus 5 electrons, it will give rise to Mn plus 2 plus 4H2O. So it is having what here, 1.52 is the standard electrode potential value. Okay, so coming to here, this is having more high standard electrode potential value. So by this, what we can say here, this is the most powerful oxidizing agent. Okay, so this is the most powerful oxidizing agent. We can say it will undergoes oxidation, we can easily say. Okay, so not only this, if you have been seen Cr2O72 minus, that one also is having 1.33. that one will not undergo, it is having low reduction value. And HgFeCuISn, if you have been taken, that cannot oxidize the Mn plus 2 and Cl minus. Why? Because Mn plus 2 and Cl minus is having electrode potential values more. In the presence of acids, we are going to do that solutions. Okay, so to overcome that solution, we are going to use a dichromate, that one which is used as a lower potential, which will oxidize Fe plus 2. Okay, so now basing upon this, the standard potential values when you have been taken, it will give the spontaneous reaction, but will it not give the rate of the reaction. Okay, so this is a standard electrode potential. By this, what we can say, it will give spontaneous reactions, means feasibility of the reactions it is going to give, but not the rate of the reaction it is not going to give. So this is about introduction of the redox reactions. Let us take an example here, potassium permanganate KMnO4. Okay, if you have been taken KMnO4, so generally the KMnO4 potassium permanganate, when you do titration with oxalic acid or some acids, strong acids, HCl. So here we are saying that this KMnO4 itself uses as a self indicator. Why? Because it is undergoing both oxidation and also reduction reactions. okay. So then coming to here, the color will be what here, pale pink we are going to get. Generally we are not going to use any indicator. Why? Because this MnO4 itself is acting as a indicator, we are going to say. So if you want to add indicator also, it should have very low solution, means diphenyl sulfonic acid or the phenanthrin iron complexes are used as indicators, which is containing dilute permanganate solution. What we can say here, for dilute, for low concentration, for dilute permanganate solutions which is having low concentration, we are going to use indicators as a diphenyl sulfonic acid or orthophenanthrolone iron complex. So these are the indicators we are going to use, okay. But coming to here, for acidic solutions, if you take acids like H plus and Cl minus, for strong acids, for strong acids, what we are going to get here, for strong acid, the equation will be MnO4 plus 8H plus plus 5 electrons. It will give Mn plus 2 plus 4H2O. Why? Because in the presence of strong acid we have taken, so the electrode potential value will be 1.55 electron volts. If suppose if you take weak acidic, weakly acidic, or neutral compounds, or weakly basic, for these compounds you are going to have this equation like MnO4 plus 4H plus plus 3 electrons. It will give MnO2 plus 2H2. Here the electrode potential value will be more, okay. If suppose strong base, then it is going to give MnO4 minus plus electron, MnO4 2 minus. So the electrode potential value will be 0.56 V. See here, if you take strong acid, the electrode potential value will be 1.55. If you take weak, then it will be 1.66. If you take strong base, it is giving 0.56 volts. By this, what we can see here, here we are not adding any catalyst. The permanganate ion itself acting as a catalyst in the presence of light, heat, acids, bases, right? So the N, Mn plus 2 and MnO2, MnO we are going to get. So by this, what we can say here, this MnO2 act as autocatalyst effect, autocatalytic effect. So autocatalytic effect is nothing but what here, so here autocatalytic effect is nothing but this permanganate ion itself acting as a catalyst. It is not involving any catalyst, right? So here, to avoid, for preparing standard KMnO4 solution, they should be compulsory, the permanganate should be, whatever the permanganate we are taking, it should be stored in a colored flask. When you store in a colored flask only, we are going to get the standard KMnO4 solutions, okay. So by this, we are going to get the here, in the presence of light or in the presence of heat, potassium permanganate is not considered as a, so KMnO4, in the presence of light or in the presence of heat, it is not considered as a primary standard solution. Wrong. So if you take in a burette, I am taking here potassium permanganate, yes or no? When you take in a burette, we take always potassium permanganate. Why? Because it is a primary standard compound, we are saying. So coming to here, the permanganate in the presence of light, means when you prepare in the presence of light or in the heat, it will not give primary standard solution. If you prepared in the colored bottles only, it will give you a primary standard solution. Okay. So here the end point will be what here? Here the end point will be, for this compound, pale pink is the end point. So this is about redox titrations, and we are going to have iodometry. This is one of the example. We are having iodometry and iodimetry also. Iodometry is different, iodimetry is different. So let us see first of all iodometry. Iodometry is nothing but direct titrations. Direct titrations we call it as iodometry. Iodometry is nothing but indirect titrations, we call it as iodometry. Okay, so in iodometry here, iodine is used as a standard solution. But coming to in iodometry here, I2 is evolved. Means the gas, whatever it is giving, the I2 is going to give. So this is nothing but iodometry. Okay. So it consists of generally iodine two types, that is. So standard solution of iodine, if you use it to titrate with some oxidizing substances, then iodine will be a weak oxidant. If suppose iodine is liberating in the reaction here, it will act like a, so this is a here. Strong oxidizing agent in iodometry, whereas hypo, when you do it titration, it will give a reducing agent. Okay, so then what we are getting, so the director iodometry titration is called indirector iodometry titration. Okay, so let us take the half cell reaction, I2 plus 2 electrons. It is giving I minus. So this is what reduction half cell reaction. Reduction half cell reaction. Coming to here, now this iodide will react with I2 and it will give I3 minus triiodide. So this is the triiodide reaction. Then by this what we can get the overall reaction, I3 minus plus 2 electrons, it will give 3I minus. Whereas the electrode potential value will be 0.536 volts. So this is the general reaction we have got. But if you take weak ox, it is a weak oxidizing agent. Okay. So this one what we can say? Weak oxidizing agent. For low oxidizing power, generally with a Stannous agent like Sn plus 2 plus I2, it will give Sn plus 4 first 2i minus. With H2S, if you take I2, it will give S plus 2H plus 2i minus. With sulfite, it will give SO3 2 minus plus I2 plus H2O. It will give SO4 2 minus plus 2H plus 2i minus. If suppose 2S2O3 2 minus plus I2, it will give S4O6 2 minus plus 2I minus. Okay, so this is weak oxidizing agents when it is liberating I. When you reacting with I2 with these compounds, it is giving only I minus. So when you take here weak reducing agents. So these all are weak oxidizing agents. This is weak reducing agent. Then you are going to get here H3ASO3 plus I2 plus H2O. It will give H3ASO4 2H plus 2I minus. So this is the weak reducing agent. Okay.